How much does a furnace fan motor cost? I think mine went out in the past few days, so the whole house is starting to freeze at night.
No amount seems like too much when your family and your furnace are giving you a cold shoulder.
The furnace runs, but that doesn't matter if there isn't a working fan to distribute the hot air through the house.
Yeah, and it's pity there are no politicians to generate spare hot air for your family.
Only over the holidays. But I need a furnace fan motor soon, and I need to know how much the fan motors cost.
Furnace fan motor prices depend in price on the power involved.
Electric.
A half horsepower fan blower motor is $125 if you're getting one for Rheem or Ruud. A 3/4 horsepower motor is $140.
I understand that. You pay more for a furnace with more BTUs and an AC with more air movement capacity, so the same concept is reasonable for a fan motor.
An equally powerful A.O. Smith motor is around $200.
So you pay more for a brand name fan blower motor too.
You pay more if you get the one built by the original equipment manufacturer or OEM. If you can use a third-party blower motor, you'll usually save less.
How much cheaper is the lower power motor?
A third horsepower blower motor by A.O. Smith is around $100. An equivalent motor from Lennox is $140.
It makes me want to look for a used or reconditioned motor.
A used motor is cheaper, but you're paying for one that is going to fail sooner.
I'm just hoping to save money on the repairs.
Get a fan motor from an appliance depot, like when they removed the old furnace whose heat exchanger broke, and you'll get a barely used fan motor for less than the prices I gave.
But then you don't know how much life it has.
Furnace fan motors aren't that expensive compared to things like the control panel or the labor costs to repair it.
The cost of the guy just showing up is close to $100 today, even if he just hits the furnace's reset button.
Go ahead and budget $100 to $200 if the repair isn't under the warranty. And another $100 for the labor.
What happens if the part is under warranty?
You'll probably have to pay the labor costs anyway, since most warranties only cover the parts unless the unit failed in its first month of operation.
And pay premium labor for their authorized repair people, since a lot of warranty work isn't covered if you pay a cheap local guy to do it.
The warranties usually require factory authorized parts or manufacturer parts too.
But if they pay for the part, I don't care about its price. Well, the labor, but not the price of the part, only its quality.